Namaste. This is Mekhala here from poojas.in. In today's video, I want to talk to you about a very interesting and obvious question a friend of mine asked me. Her name is Padma, and she was asking me, why do you call your website as poojas.in? Why aren't you calling it astro services or something related to astrology, like astro Mekhala or something like that? So why are you calling yourself, poojas.in is what she asked me. So I said, that's very interesting, because the thing is, astrology is just the starting point of transformational life, wherein you know your life plan, like I mentioned, and then you find out what's going on in your life, what you can expect, and how you can make corrections. But the actual corrections do happen when you do the poojas, because poojas are so ancient, and they are techniques where you connect to God instantly through certain vibrations. Like, for example, when we do havans or japs or mantras, we chant it in a particular frequency. And when we chant it in a particular frequency, we reach God, because that frequency is where the God and God's energy also vibrates. So the connection is instantaneous. And when I talk about havans, we through Agni in Sanatana Dharma, we say that he is the one who carries your prayers to the gods and God's energy to you. It's through the Agni only. So which is why the sacred fire is lit, and then we do the havans. So and we all know that very well, that when the havans take place, the gods have to descend to earth and they have to give you prasad. So we know for sure that your problem is going to be addressed, and your issue is going to be resolved. So you know that the issue is going to be resolved, and that's exactly why we have called ourselves poojas.in. I'll give you a small example. For example, you assume you want to call your friend. Say, okay, let me take the example of my friend only. Say I want to call my friend Padma. If I just say like that, if I call her, will she be able to turn? If there are 10 people there, how does she know it's me? So it has to be my voice, it has to be her name. I should say, hey Padma, turn around, you know, something like that. So then I catch her attention, and then I should be loud enough. If I just say, Padma, come here, if I just whisper like this, she may not hear, she may also hear. So like that, what we do is, when we chant, there are certain priests who chant it. So when they chant it, because of their rigorous practice and the anushthana bala, so that is like the strength of their practice, they would have gained certain powers. So with that power, if they call, the gods have to turn and see. They have to ask, yes, what do you want? And they have to respond to your prayers. So that is the beauty and power of what we're doing. You know, it's just not simply something random. But you know, it doesn't mean that silent prayers don't work. Definitely they do, and they're as powerful as the prayers which we do through mantras and Vedas, then tantric way of approaching divinity. But the silent prayers work best when you yourself pray. For example, silent prayers should always emanate from the heart, and nobody can understand your problems better than you, because you are living your problems, you are experiencing it every day, the pain that you're going through, everything, you know exactly what's happening. So when you actually pray silently from your heart, you just have to open out your heart and just tell God what you feel. And then when you close your eyes and just make that one prayer, I'm telling you, you really don't need any puja or anything like that. But the prayer has to be with that conviction, and you should know for sure that your God has heard it. Only then it will work. Because I know many people, when they actually make a prayer, they just pray and they say, oh, I really want something to happen. They pray, but they're like, I prayed, but I'm not so sure if God heard it. I prayed, but I'm not so sure if it will be answered. You know, these kind of dual thoughts and duality in prayers, it's not going to help you in any way. You have to be sure that you have said it right, and you have to be sure that God has heard it. That is when, and it can be any God, whichever God you pray to, you just make sure that you are aware that your God is close to you, your God is within you, and you're praying. So this is another thing that I would like to advocate, because I don't want people to be dependent on pujas. I just want you to understand that pujas can empower you and take you to a certain distance. So do it at the right time, get the benefit, and then go on. Like, pujas is like going on a highway. So, but every day, everybody doesn't go on a highway. So practically every day it may not be possible for you to do pujas, but you go on your state road, you go on your village road, you go on the city roads. So when you're going like that, then you need some kind of energy. for which I recommend you do the daily prayers at home, you do your meditation, you do your mantra sadhana or japa. You know, all this is going to give you a lot of energy to take your activities. And sometimes if you feel your vehicle of life is moving very slow and you need a thrust and you need a push and you need to get to a destination very fast, then you choose the best exit road. You go, you can go through your underpass or you can go through some, toll gates and things like that where you pay a little more, but you make sure you reach your destination on time and have a smooth journey. Exactly, that's what we do at poojas.in. We are that toll gate. We are that road which you take to reach your destination faster. So if you feel you have a budget, if you feel you have the time to get a puja done, if you're willing, if you feel you have a heart, which is most important here, is the heart and the willingness to do a puja. If you feel all these things are there ready, then that means you're ready for a puja. And when you are ready for a puja, we are ready for to serve you with the best kind of priests available, with the most powerful mantras, and on we can do it on a very good date at a very good price. So here what happens is that everything will be so conducive for you to go ahead and do your best and reach your destination, reach your goal, achieve your whatever you want to achieve, and make sure your dreams are realized. So which is why we call ourselves poojas.in. We just don't cater to telling you what your life plan is all about as per your chart, but we also tell you how to get there, and poojas will help you get there faster. So which is why we are called as poojas.in. With that, I think I have answered my friend's question to much to her satisfaction. And even if you have these questions in your mind, I'm so sure that these questions are answered through this video. If you have any questions, please feel free to drop your comments below this video so that I can get back to you with another video answering your question. Thank you so much. Namaste.